Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to select parts of a complex image in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I have this image here in Illustrator, and the first way to do this is with your group selection tool. So I'm going to get on that now. It's the little white one with a plus symbol. And also, it really depends on how your artwork is set up. So let's say I want to select this mountain. First, I'll click once. That selects whatever I'm hovering over. Click again in the same spot, and that'll get a little more if it's grouped correctly. And then click again to get the next part. I'll click again, and that will get the whole thing. So that's too many times. And unfortunately, you can't undo the clicks. So make sure you're counting how many clicks you're doing. So I did 3, and now I can move that wherever I want. But this method only works with groups within groups. So whoever made this made sure to, after they created the mountain, they grouped it. Then they worked on the other parts and they grouped those. So I might also be able to do that down here on the grass. I'll click once, I'll click again and again. Okay, so part of it's grouped and part isn't. We've got just the mountain, but this stuff isn't grouped down here. It's probably its own group. So I'll try that. And no, so it doesn't work down here. But anyway, if the creator grouped it in a logical way, that group selection tool is so useful to just select different parts and move them around. Another way to select things is by color. So you can use the magic wand tool. And to get to that, you can hit Y on your keyboard. It's right over here. You can also double click on this and change your tolerance to increase or decrease what's being selected by color. And I always leave just the fill color selected, but you can mess with these other ones if your artwork is made up of those. I've got my tolerance at 32, and I'll just click this blue piece down here to see what it gets. Okay, so it's grabbing everything that is pretty close to this dark blue, but it didn't get this other one. So you can hold shift and try selecting another piece to add it to that. So if I hide this with Command-3 or Control-3, that pretty much got everything in the foreground except for these pieces. And then with my wand tool, I can click on those and hide them. Now I've completely removed my foreground, and I'll bring it back with Option-Command-3 or Alt-Control-3. And now I can group this with Command-G. So when I click it with my selection tool, it's all one piece. Now, if you want only the exact same fill color and not similar fill colors, you can use your group or direct selection to click on one piece and do select same fill color. And that will get everything that's exactly that fill color. It can't be a little bit different. It has to be exactly the same. By the way, I got all of these images from Vecteezy for free, and you can do that too. Vecteezy allows you to download a lot of free images, so it's a good resource. The third way I want to show you to select things is by using the Q tool, which is the lasso tool, this one right here. With this method, I switch back and forth between outline mode and preview. And to do that, you can hit Command Y or Control Y. So I do this to see kind of what I'm up against. I'll hit Command Y. You can see we have a ton of paths here. So it's going to be kind of complicated to isolate some parts of this. But let's say I want just this little penguin right here. I'll hit Q on my keyboard to get to my lasso tool right up here. And I'm just going to lasso around this little guy. And that'll get some things I don't want, and that's okay. So I'll Command X or Control X to cut. I'll select all with Control A or Command A and then hit delete. And then I'll paste. Now I have just a penguin and some stuff I don't really want. I'll get on my group selection tool. So now I'm just going to draw boxes around the things I don't want, being careful not to touch the little penguin. And I'll just hit delete. Problem is, some of these things are probably going to be connected. Like this red is connected to his little hat. So we'll have to figure that out. But I'll just do what I can for now. I'll get on my Q tool and I will draw around this stuff. I'm going to get on my G tool. Well, I have it set for G, but it's your group selection tool. You probably won't have that set up. I'm going to click off on all the little pieces that I can tell are connected to him, and then I'll delete. And I think that's pretty good. I'll hit delete a couple times to make sure I get all those points. I can also use my group selection to draw a box, making sure not to touch any penguin parts, and then just delete those. And we will get these up here. There are some really small little yellow things up here. So I'm going to do select same fill color to select some of those and delete. I've got a keyboard shortcut set up for those. Got some little gray pieces. I'm just selecting those with my group selection tool, holding shift to get more than one at a time, and then just deleting. This is looking kind of weird because it was attached to that other part. So we kind of need to redraw this. To do that, I'll get on my end tool. That is my pencil tool right here. And I'm just going to start in one direction and then end up going the same direction. And I'll also do that with this red piece. I'll click here and I'll start going one direction. I'm going to come down and around here, and then I'll end up going that same direction back here. Okay, and so this is pretty good. I have some little things to fix here and there, and this has obviously been image traced, which isn't the greatest. I think sometimes people want this look, sort of a hand-drawn look. So, you know, it does have its place, but I personally prefer a cleanly made with the pen tool little penguin. So that's how to isolate something using the group selection and the lasso tool. And now I've taken all three isolated parts and put them together into a new, very weird scene. But anyway, that's how you can kind of select pieces of your artwork in case you do need it to be separated. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it. You'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you next week with another graphic design video. Thank you.